Matt here with Keeping Up YYC. Today we're joined by Jessica Erlendson of MusicAndYoga.online. How are you today, Jessica?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for asking. We'll get right into it. Tell us a little bit about your business.
Well, I'm a private music instructor. I'm the daughter of a jazz musician, so it's kind of natural to follow in his footsteps. And I've been teaching music for 20 years. About 5 years ago, I broke my elbow when I fell down. And when you break your elbow, the advice is to keep it moving, but not too much, which I found very frustrating, but it got me back into doing yoga. And I really loved it. And I realized that I've always wanted to do yoga teacher training. And so I eventually went and did that. And while I was there, I found yoga therapy, which is therapeutic applied yoga. So instead of just, you know, everybody benefits from moving, it's specifically helping you with whatever issue you might be having. So I've worked with, you know, chronic illness, people who need to function even though they are sick, rehabilitation and emotional problems and fertility issues. It's really exciting. So instead of changing directions completely, I've just incorporated the yoga therapy into what I do already. So I'm still teaching music and I'm also doing the one-on-one yoga therapy sessions.
Okay, so yoga therapy, that sounds to me, that's got to be extremely tailored to the specific individual's needs. Is that right?
Yeah. So if you were my client, you would take the time to do an intake, a medical intake.
Okay.
So I would get your complete medical history before we do anything. And then we would work through your doshas, which is kind of, you know, you can sort of think of it as your body type. But that gives me an idea of what to tailor for you. And it's very similar to the music lessons, actually, because you would come to me and say, I want to learn to play, you know, guitar. And I would try and figure out what exactly are you looking for before I start teaching you.
Oh, okay.
And then I would be doing the same idea of tailoring it directly to you, because maybe what you really want to do is just play some songs around the campfire, as opposed to someone else who really wants to learn to play classical guitar and finger picking style.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to make sure that the individual is getting their needs met. So it's really not all that different. They both involve a lot of discipline and persistence and self-care, you know.
Okay, so that brings up another question. When you say music lessons, what type of music can you teach, and what instruments more specifically are you capable of teaching people?
I teach piano, voice, flute, and guitar.
Piano, voice, flute, and guitar. Okay,
yeah.
Gotcha.
So that's why I mentioned my father. My father, Bob Erlendson, is a jazz musician, and he is a composer. So his mentoring of me always went along the lines of, you really want to follow your interest. So instead of having like a structured, this kid's going to play piano, he did teach me piano, but he also encouraged me to learn anything else that I was interested in. So I learned how to play bass guitar, regular guitar, acoustic guitar, electric guitar, soprano saxophone, flute, some B flat horn, percussion, singing in choirs and in bands and folk bands and jazz bands and all kinds of anything I was interested in. So, you know, you add that up over the course of a lifetime and I've developed, you know, skills in these different areas. But what I'm really good at is figuring out what the student needs and then helping them to get to a place where they feel like they can do what they want.
That's what it's all about, yeah.
Yeah.
So my next question is, what are you doing to adapt in this environment?
Well, I designed the new website, musicandyoga.online, and I'm really catering to the whole online environment. And instead of, you know, there's been a lot of lamenting about the challenges that we have being online, I have focused on the benefits. And there are a lot of benefits to being online. And so I upgraded my computer and I got a, there's a particular kind of camera that you can buy that has a musician's microphone so that my end of the lesson sound as good as possible. So when the student is listening, if I have to demonstrate something, they can hear it very well. Sure. And I got a better internet connection and I've just been honing my online skills. Okay. So really streamlining everything. So, and it's been interesting, like I've done problem solving of things that never would have come up because I'm seeing how the student is practicing, or with the yoga, I'm watching them in their home environment. So I can help them do little tweaks of where they have their chair or how they're using their props in a way that I wouldn't normally be able to do so that they have a more satisfying practice experience and then they want to do it more.
Absolutely. So
it's been really good, like in a lot of ways. I think it's better because I can encourage their home practice so much more. And then there's the things that are the drawbacks. My personality and my take on that is I just don't emphasize that. So if something goes wrong, I just let it go as quickly as possible, which has been excellent training for remaining flexible.
Absolutely.
Right? Like we, you know, you want to be adaptable and flexible and.
Yeah, that's the name of the game today, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So why is it important for people to support local businesses?
Well, I think the most obvious one is that we keep the money where we are. You're spending your money in your own community, so you're supporting people who are also going to spend the money in the community rather than spending your money on, you know, Amazon. And they're not going to notice if you don't buy the little thing you were going to buy and instead you support someone else. Like for my own self, when I was thinking about it, it's been about finding people that are making things or providing an individual service that is really special. And then using that as gifts for people for Christmas. And that's been really fulfilling for me because I feel really good about sharing what people I know are working on with other people who maybe wouldn't know. But yeah, now they do.
Yeah, it feels great. There's a lot of cool stuff that Calgarians are doing. That's for sure.
Yeah, it's been one of the things where as far as like music, for example, if you look on the international scene, you're not going to see a lot of artists from Calgary, but that doesn't mean the talent isn't here. There are a lot of very talented musicians and there are a lot of very talented people working in yoga in Calgary right now, and they desperately need the support. So one of the things I've been encouraging people to do is if you have a musician that you like, get them to do a little concert for you. They can do a little virtual concert from their home to yours. And right at this point, they're happy to do that.
Yeah, that's a great idea, actually.
Why not?
I agree 100%.
Yeah.
Cool. Last question I have for you is, do you have any tips and tricks you can share in relation to your expertise?
I think the biggest tip, you know, thinking about it for myself is, find someone that you really want to work with. Because in yoga and music, the one thing that really comes across is a mentor. Really need someone that you can relate to, that you feel very much listens to what you need, because that's been something that comes up a lot where your needs might change. And whoever's working with you needs to adapt as you grow. And, you know, that's a very special relationship. So it's important to find the right person to mentor you, more than like, do they have all the great credentials or are they associated with this, you know, entity or have they achieved this level of recognition? It's more important to find someone that you feel comfortable with, especially when, you know, you're practicing in front of them. It's kind of embarrassing, right?
Vulnerable. It's a vulnerable situation.
You have to be in a place where you really trust them and they're going to guide you with that, you know, constructive, you know, in a way it's like you get paid to criticize people because you have to guide them, but that they're able to do that in a way that you can hear and are open to and feel cared for and respected.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So finding those relationships and then nurturing them.
Yeah, I agree. That's what it's all about from a teaching and mentoring perspective, for sure.
Exactly.
So that's actually all the questions I had prepared for you, Jessica. We do ask that you end the interview by looking at the camera, stating your name as well as your business name, and just asking people to keep it local, keep it YYC.
Hi, I'm Jessica Erlendson at www.musicandyoga.online. Keep it local, keep it YYC.